this mead thing that I screwed up the other day when I was on Live with Martha. When I remembered that I had promised to show you guys how I repaired it. So, here we go. At least what I've got so far. Now, this part is stuck to the board. This part isn't yet. I've got it back on the pattern. And you will not believe what this stupid thing did when it fell apart. But anyway, we'll get into that as we go along here. Put that out of the way. Most of what's missing is black beads, but there are a few other ones. I'm not exactly sure how it split the way it did. So, I'm trying to open a plastic container where I put the leftover beads because I'm half afraid I didn't find all the beads that came off the work. And besides, I need the needle. Now, I know Miss Martha said to use fishing line. I ain't got none. And this is the stuff that came in the kit to do this. So, we're gonna use that. First thing I gotta do is thread a needle. That means I need my specs. Yeah, my glasses. This would help if I cleaned them first. Excuse me half a second. Now, I wish I could figure everything out, but I can't. So we're going to do what we have to do. And we start by threading the dang needle. If I can keep from dropping the needle on the floor, which is what just happened. Okay, let's find the needle. It didn't get stuck in my skirt. Grab the grabber. Now, I have been told many times that it is best if everybody gets to see even your big mistakes. So, I'm not shutting off the camera. Yep, I got a snack box under my desk. And I think the needle might have fallen in there. But I ain't found it yet. Oh, yep, there it is. I was right. It was in the candy box. And no, I'm not going to show you the candy box. You guys are going to say, but you're a diabetic, that's excessive. But when what you do is you send somebody to pick up your groceries from Walmart, you sometimes get more than you bargain for in certain things. Especially when your pre-order gets adjusted by Walmart. Yeah, I ordered a bunch of stuff from Walmart. And apparently they were out of some of this stuff. And so they changed what I ordered instead of contacting me and asking what to do about it. So, in all the cases, the small package got shifted to a much larger package that they did have. Now, I might have done that, but I wish they'd have called me first, which they could have done. But this will last me about 2 months, I hope. Depends. I've got an 11-year-old grandnephew and a 3-year-old grandniece running around the house. So it may not last as long as I want it to. You know how little ones are if they find a candy stash. Okay. We shall thread the needle. And pull off about an arm span. And about a half more. About that. Now, next step, don't drop the threaded needle. And cut it free from the spool. One threaded needle. Now, let's find the end without tangling all this thread. Put that up there so I don't drop it. And we're gonna tie what is sometimes called a milliner's knot. You take the thread around like you're making your shoelaces, then you take that same thread and get around again. Now you're going to take the two ends, cross them, like you're going to make a shoelace knot again. Go through, take that same end, and go through again. This makes, the other name for it is a double butcher's knot. Because the butcher only does it once on the bottom, whereas the milliner, that's a hat maker if you don't know, does it twice. It's supposed to be stronger than any knot. And if I understand the history correctly, back in the old days, hat makers would actually tie one of those knots in a piece of silk thread to tie a hat with that single strand with one of those knots at each end. One end of that single strand of silk tied to their shop sign, the other end tied to the hat. This was supposed to prove that they made the best hats in town because the wind would blow and the hat didn't blow away because they used a proper knot. That's an old story that actually supposedly happened in the Edwardian days, which is where this knot dates to. Now, before we get too started here, let's go back to the other camera. Okay, that's me and my specs. Lots of people ask about this thing, and I'm going to put a link into in the description of this thing to my blog, where I go into some detail as to exactly why I wear this thing over my eye. But that's neither here nor there at the moment. Just a warning. Eventually, I'll be able to have surgery on my eye and fix it. But that's not now. That may not be for 6 months. Apparently, eye surgeons are in extreme short supply in my neck of the woods. But that's okay, too. I can survive this way. Now, I have my pan of beads. My needle is threaded and attached to securely to the beadwork. Very securely. This part of the beadwork is actually pinned to the board. That's important, because we don't want it shifting as I'm trying to figure out how it all goes back together. I think I may have already said that Miss Martha, when I busted it, said I should use fishing line to put it back together. But I don't have any of that. And this is the thread that came with the kit. So, it's not Nymo. It's some other stuff that was sent along with this kit. Now, this kit was created, if I remember correctly from the paperwork, back in 2001. That is... Oh, yeah, you do see. I'm picking up a single bead and putting it where it belongs. Now, this side here is the weird side of this odd count peyote. So, now that I've chewed the last bead that needs to be replaced on this side, I take the black one. I put it on. That. Now you know. I'm a klutz. Oh well. I still managed to get an awful lot of crafting done. Okay, we got that there. We go through between these two beads. Because we have to secure the end. Now. If I've got this measured correctly, the next thing I need to do is start running the zipper, which is the easy part, some people seem to think. Okay, the next thing we're missing is a red bead. So, we're gonna go through there. Make sure that is tight and in the direction it belongs in. And add a red bead. Oh crap. Is that a red bead? Nope. I go into the thing looking for a red bead and pull out an amber one. Oh well. This has happened before. You just undo it and start again. Because you don't want stupid beads in the wrong places. So now, let's get a real red one. Okay, light, We need more light. Maybe we need to move the light the other way. I don't want so much glare. It's not too bad. That's a red one. Okay, now we put that then through this bead. And once again, we pull tight until that bead pops right into where it belongs. Now we need a black bead. They're easy to find. And go through the clear bead there. This has got so much clear background, it bugs me, but hey, I'll deal with whatever I have to here. Because this cannot be allowed to fall apart. Now, I'm going to go from there, because this now will fit back together. So, I'm going to come back through here, through there, through, if I can get it to bend a little, there, through there, and okay, now, we've got half the zipper on this end at least. Now we pull everything tight and hope that clear bead goes back where it belongs. Did I get it tangled? A little bit. Let's see if we can untangle our stupid work. What did it do? Oh, that's what it did. That is not what we were trying to do. Okay. That's the t'other end. Okay, now we go through here to make the knot on the side, which we need to do. This out of our way temporarily. Go through there, 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 and pull out there. Now we gotta go there. Put this bead on and go through that one. Not that one. I know it'd probably be more helpful for you guys if I could actually zoom this camera, which I cannot do. Now, with it there, we're gonna come over here. Through there, pop that back down in, take these two, and tie another knot. Yes, I'm going to do another milliner's knot under, over, twice. A pull twice. Pull it tight down in there. Now we're going to do it again. And once again, we're going to go around and through. Up, around and through. Not just once, but twice. We need this to be the strongest knot possible. So, that's what we're doing. And pull that one tight. We'll worry about coming back and trimming that off later. Now, we're going to come through here. Now, this project really did some screwy stuff when it came apart. So, the next step is to get back to where it's boosted. So we come up here. And now, normally with Peyote Stitch, you just zip two pieces together. You go from there, you go. Oh, I went too far. Okay. And you come back. But since the two ends of Peyote Stitch fit together like a zipper, you just zip them through. Taking one from this end, one from that, one from this, next one from that, and you keep going across. Up. That was not the way it was supposed to go. I skipped a few beads there. So we pull it back out, and we go on. The problem with this is, oops, yeah, where am I? Now, which strand is my needle? Well, that ain't my needle. Yes, that is my needle. Okay. So we go here, and then there, and then pull it out here, and then there, and pull it out. Then we go here, and then there. Bottom piece, top piece, something like that. I wish I could show you more close up, but it ain't happening. Because my camera won't zoom. This should not be surprising to you, since I got it from Slovo from China. Yeah, I'm sure most of you know what I mean by that. But that's as most as I'm going to say about that. Now, like I said, this particular pattern is out of date. It was discontinued years ago, but I had it, so I figured I'd do it up. There are companies still making these banners. So if you would like to buy one, not sponsored, trust me, I wish I was, but I'm not, I've looked up and found three different companies, all will be listed in the description box below, that actually sell these beading kits. I don't know, considering how much beads I've got for making my own designs, whether I will be getting any more kits myself. Probably not. I did promise I would show you how to design one of these suckers. So, that's going to be the next step when we get back to beading. I've got a few other things planned. I've got my niece's wedding album to do, the baby album to do, and I've got a few digitals I just put up at Etsy and at my website. So, you know, now they're available at either place. I don't know which way would be easier for you, because that's that. But here's the thing. With Etsy's stupidness, where they are requiring that their sellers go free postage to the US for $35 or more, I won't be putting physical products on Etsy. Now, that's okay. I've got the WooCommerce site on my blog, and so that is probably the way I'm gonna go with Solin. Although, hey, from what I understand, if you do like YouTube auctions, like certain other YouTubers do, you don't have to worry about sales tax mess because they don't. Of course, you could get in trouble. I'm drinking lemonade. No, there is no alcohol in my lemonade. Now I'm going to flip this around so you can see the other side. And here's the deal. I don't know how it happened, but all the black beads on the outermost row came off. Now, that shouldn't have happened. Something weird happened, and I don't know how that occurred. But they did all come off, and they didn't break, they just came off. And so, I gotta put them back on now. This is a little different, because I don't think I have to go back all the way back every row to just add the last beads on this thing. I don't know how it came apart like this. I don't know why. Because you would think with all the black beads gone, the whole thing would have disintegrated. But I'm not finding any breaks in the beads that came off. So, it's a mystery, and oh well. I didn't put them on extra. The thread goes from one side to the other and back again, just like it's supposed to. How they got off that end, your guess is probably as good as mine, if not better. But I'm gonna take a 2-minute break here, and we're gonna chat. So, we're back to you seeing me. Yeah, I took my glasses off. That's why I need the break, kind of. I'm not exactly sure how this sucker did what it did, and that's not good. Hey, I'm rolling a cigarette. There are a few things we should chat about. I did what I was told. And I have 2 Facebook pages, besides my personal page, which I was told to keep out of this mess from YouTube. The one is a group for my followers called Livecraft Clay. at the moment, I think the only member is my mommy. And she's only a member because I did that. She's on the net, but she's not as net savvy as some 75-year-olds. I don't know. If Mom ever finds out I said her age on the net, she might be mad at me. But then again, my niece Shauna only became a member of my YouTube channel because, well, my nephew Thomas had to, in an attempt to find out if I had gone live through StreamYard. This is not through StreamYard. This is OBS to make a tutorial. I can go live through this, but it's a lot harder than StreamYard. And you can't invite in any guests. Which means these things were a lot less fun. On the agenda of things I want to put on film, I've got two scrapbooks, the old-fashioned kind that get photographs on every page, and a junk journal, at least one, possibly two. I want to get now everybody says you should do a December daily. Well, I have never been able to complete a December daily. Now, a lot of my Christmas stuff we're going to be doing in the next few weeks, because I make a lot of Christmas decor items, which I have to give them to the person I'm giving them to as an early Christmas present. I usually give them to them on Thanksgiving. That way they can use them in their Christmas decor that year instead of opening them up Christmas morning and packing them away the day after New Year's. They can actually put them on display and use them and enjoy them the entire Christmas season. You won't see much fall decor or Halloween stuff, although I do have a paper pack made up for that. But that's because, you live with an 11-year-old and a 3-year-old in your house. They like Halloween. Thanksgiving, well, if the house is clean and the turkey is actually properly cooked, we don't worry about decor. I told you. Mom is, and then there's me, and then there's Shauna and her husband, and then there's my nephew and my grandniece. The nephew is a grandnephew, because Shauna is his mama, and that's my sister's oldest. So it's a confused mess. But I've got lots of stuff that has to get done. I got a nice cabinet that I'm filling slowly with craft supplies. I've got a shelving unit here that is stuffed to the gills already. I've got the shelving unit on the other side of my cabinet. I've got a shelving unit over on that side that I still have to put stuff on, but I can't get to that. Under my desk, I've got a garbage can, my snack bucket, and my pocketbook. Safest place to keep it. Under the camera, I've got a box with files in it. And I've got another file box here that I still have to fill up. And believe me, I can fill it up with the paper stuff I've got. We could get into some paper construction eventually. I don't know. I have to check and see if what I've got, because there are companies on the net that give away free temporary decor items. They're paper construction, paper engineering. You print out the instructions, you print out the pieces, and you put them together, trim them out, and glue them together, and they last for a while, but remember, they're only papers, so they ain't gonna last forever. Party decorations. But they also have, like, toys and stuff that if you printed them out and glued them to cardboard, you might be able to make something more permanent if the kids aren't too rough with them. Of course, since when are kids not rough with paper toys? That's the other thing I gotta do. Gotta get the foam core together because I gotta make 2 advent calendars this year. I wanna make them out of foam core. That way, they're there. And then we just have to fill them up every year instead of making a new one every year. This past year, I took some fun foam and some paper boxes and made 2 advent calendars. This year, I'm gonna take some foam core, cover it with paper. Yeah, I did say cover it with paper. And put it together and make an actual fairly permanent advent calendar. But that will not be for a while. I've got to get myself to the Dollar Tree. Now, with this, I ain't driving. Not that I actually could, because, hey, I ain't got a vehicle. But we're just gonna assume that I can do what I have to do, which in this case is get whoever takes me to the foot doctor at the end of the month to stop at the big Dollar Tree. I mean, we got a Dollar Tree in town, but got one of the smaller versions. And so we've got this gonna be kind of mess. And all these pins are causing me trouble trying to do all this stitching. But I'm getting there. Yeah. It's not exactly peyote stitch what I'm doing right now. It's just put the thread where it'll go, then it will hold the beads where they look right. So I'll get this done, and it's not ever gonna be perfect, but hey, it'll be done. It'll look like it is done right, and we can move on to something else. Okay, I'll put the camera back so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just putting the needle through, bringing the needle back, I'm going through the same bead I just put on there, because I've got to find a way that they don't gap away from each other when they're hanging. So, I hope this works. I don't want to have to tear this whole thing apart and do it over. I was kind of hoping that this could be one of the things I give to somebody on Thanksgiving. Although I don't know if that's gonna work, because hey, most of my family's got more than enough stuff that I did, and they'll tell you so if you'd ever ask them. Now, there are some that have said maybe I should sell my work, but I wouldn't even know how to charge for something like this, because it's not perfect. Although, some of the stuff I've seen people buy from artists and crafters is confusing to me. But it's such an old kit. It's been discontinued for years. And I don't know but once I get this room organized all the way, which could be a while, I gotta wait for that nephew of mine to take the bed out of here so that I can start really moving my craft stuff in. Then I will be able to get all of the extra beads that I've gotten from other beaded banners I've done over the years, and or that I just bought. And it won't be until then that I'll be able to actually teach you how to design one, because, hey, you can't design if you don't know what you've got. what I will do once I can get the stuff in here is show you what I've got in the way of beads, and then I will show you how to design one of these banners. But right now, I can't even get up from my desk without pushing this chair all the way back to the door. No space. Almost done. Only got this far to go. Now, I know I probably shouldn't bitch about Etsy, but their free shipping thing, if I read the law right, and I did go and read the law, it's against the rules. Now, I don't know if you remember, but Amazon got in trouble for breaking that one a few years back, which is why I thought that it might be illegal and went and checked it out. Now, with what I'm selling on Etsy, it don't matter because what I'm selling is digital. And there is no shipping charges. But if I would get into selling my artwork, it's crap. I've been watching other people, and I mean, I can't. I don't know. I don't want to eBay this stuff. That just scares me. Okay, I gotta add some more thread before I run out. So, before I unthread this needle to re-thread it, I'm gonna roll myself another cigarette. Now, I got the blog, and I've got a WooCommerce on the blog, so that's that. So, I can sell physical stuff there and not worry about it. The free shipping from Etsy, that is. Mom wants me to start helping her downsize the house, which that's probably a pretty good idea, but that means selling off her dolls and some of her princess house and other collectibles. I don't know whether I'm gonna do that through Woot or eBay. Most likely, it'll be Woot. Although, I'll get my prices from eBay. Being the eldest brings a lot of responsibility, even when you're not in the best capability of doing it. Oh well. I think I'll probably live stream tomorrow. This being 8/13/2019. That'll be on the 14th. And when I do that, I'll show you my digital downloadables that I've got up. Right now I've got the same ones at Etsy and at Woot. I've got a few that are almost ready to go up that I think I'm just going to put on Woot. I don't know. Everybody I've talked to says cross-post everything, because that does get more eyeballs on your stuff. Damn, I've almost been on here an hour. That's a little surprising. Okay, we're gonna rethread the needle. I need the glasses on to find the end of the thread. But now, to tell you what I'm gonna be doing, I do everything from polymer clay to jewelry making to this kind of stuff to paper crafting. I have the equipment to do wood burning, but I don't know whether I'm going to do that or not. I'm going to, in the next, say, 3 or 4 days, make up a video to do the set as a feature or intro video on my YouTube channel. So, I'll deal with that. And then you'll see better. That ain't the right one. This is the one. Exactly what I do, because I'll have lots of samples to show you. And we'll go through all that. I'm still learning this OBS studio, and so, yeah, I'm just doing a milliner's knot, like I did before. Okay. I'm hearing the kids' TV. I hope you're not hearing it. Don't need a copyright strike with this few videos out here. Of course, the first time I actually was setting up Woot. Yes, I was setting up Woot. And then somebody said I should take a chance and try to set up OBS. Well, when I set up OBS, it advised me to test my connection to YouTube for live streaming, which I did. Guess what? I got banned. Yes, I did. There was a 30-second test stream that went where it was supposed to YouTube, but, and YouTube wouldn't tell me why, it was taken away from me, the right to live stream on YouTube for, if I remember correctly, it was 3 months. Because it was considered a strike. Which viciously confused the hell out of me. But I had to put up with it because I didn't know I could contest it. So, I started this YouTube journey with a basic thou shalt not live stream. And so, now that I've got StreamYard and I've got all this other stuff, and I can again, because it did open up, that's over a year ago. I wish this would work a little better. This is a pain. Maybe I should have done. My first instinct was just tear it down and do it again. But, oh well. Hand rolls, if you don't puff on them, they go out. I wish things were different, but I really don't want the only time I'm online to be when I'm live streaming. I also don't want the only time I'm going to be on is a tutorial like this. So, we're going to try to do a mix of the two. I'm going to try to do at least one live stream a week, and maybe one or two tutorials. Of course, you never know what's going to happen with that kind of stuff, because you don't. And so, now if I do have to tear it apart, you ain't going to see that. Sorry. I've got too many videos on this channel of me making a mess with this stupid thing. If it screws up again, it'll go into the I'll fix it later pile, and it's gonna stay there until I get around to fixing it. Maybe next Christmas. I don't know. So far, I did and filmed, which I had to get rid of because it was screwy. One. Then, well, I got maybe 10 rows into it and realized that I was using, it was just wrong. Needed to be taken apart and put back together. So, I disabled that video and started over. Okay. Then came mistake number two. And on that one, I really screwed up. Oh yeah. I had just finished the thing. I mean, it took me 3 videos, but I was now done. And so I was going back to try and get it right, and I took it off of the stupid board, and It pulled the brake. And took the top six rows off. So, I recorded another video of me working it backwards to get the top six rows on. Now, here we are again. Yeah, I just put on the last bead as far as I can tell. I gotta get it tight. I gotta get it tied. And then we're done. As far as I know. If it screws up again, I told you already, I ain't fixing it. So, we're gonna make a loop here. And make sure that stays tight. We're gonna make another loop. And this time I'm kind of making something similar to a French knot. Yeah. And I'm going to leave that attached until I put a dab of something on that knot. But I'm going to take the needle off of it so I don't lose the needle. Because now is the time that you've all been waiting for. We're going to switch the camera. Move the papers around here a minute. And there she is. Finished. Again. Now I'm going to take some time, pull the pins out, find the E6000, dot a couple of these knots, but I ain't going to worry about doing that on camera. If you liked this video, if you have watched a few, hit the like button. If you're not subscribed, subscribe. If you've got some place you can share the video, share it. If you think I'm a crazy fat old lady that doesn't deserve to be on YouTube, what are you doing still watching? You should have turned that off when you decided that. Leave me a comment. Tell me what you think. You know I love y'all. I'd pull a Lizzie and read you something inspiring and all that if I actually knew where I stuck the book. But I don't right now, so time to pull the pins. Wait. Better get the pin box over here so I don't drop pins where they don't belong. Yeah. My camera is crap. But that's okay too. Okay. Where's that pin go? All right. Stupid pin. I hope it's not on the floor. I am missing several pins. And I don't know where they went. So. Well, it stayed together. Holding it up this way without the board, so that's a good thing. Now let's fold it up until I can get that E6000 on it, which may not be until tomorrow or the day after. And like I said, love y'all. May God watch over you. I'll see you next time. Oh yeah, I'm gonna live stream tomorrow, I hope. So, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye.